Hello and welcome to another uncut video. Today we're doing a bow hunt here on Timbergold Trails, and I'm really not where I was planning on being right now, but we've got a decent mule deer buck out in front of us, so we're going to try to take him out before going where I was actually planning on going. I'm going to try to get him with the forest camo pulser, hopefully before he spots us. Looks like we got plenty of time. Don't know what was with that lag spike there. That seems to happen quite often on the first shot I take. So I don't know why that is. But hopefully it doesn't happen again. When this guy grunted, it said new trail, and I already picked up a different grunt. So I don't really know whether to hang out here or not. I'm going to see if I can get like a rediscovered trail relatively quickly. Oh yeah, I entered the Muley Bow Special. I think Tops was like 225 and the competition just started like less than 24 hours ago, so we're gonna have to run into a big boy to win that. There is the buck that I heard. Much smaller, but it is a buck, so we'll try to call him in as well. So yeah, I decided to do another uncut video. I have a fair amount of things to cover, and these are the videos, great English Flinter, these are the videos that I tend to do that. So yeah, you've probably noticed, first off, that this video does not coincide with the normal schedule. So if you didn't watch the last uncut video, basically I said that I'm going to try to upload 3 videos a week while my Christmas vacation is going on. So that's going to be till early January. I'm going to try anyway to do 3 videos a week, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday at 10 p.m. Eastern. That's the plan anyway. Who knows how that's going to go. But yeah, so that's the first thing. If you didn't already know that, I am trying to upload 3 videos a week. Is that buck stuck? Because it looks like he's moving. Or trying to move. Oh, okay. He's coming down this way now. If he stops, I think we're going to try to take him with a reverse draw rather than spend a bunch of time waiting on him. So 50 meters is quite doable. It's a little easier when he's actually stopped, though. So next time he stops, depending on how far that is, we're going to try to shoot him. He's got like a cool looking sticker. Let's see if we can just get him from there. Every time. Deer don't like me in this game, especially when I try to shoot far. They don't stay still for very long when they're far away, but they'll stand there and stop behind a tree like this. Now he's going to stay there for a long time. Just wait. We're going to try to move because he's such a small buck. I definitely don't want to just hang out here and spend 5 minutes to wait for like a 80 scoring mule deer. So we're going to move his way. Well, guess he's not going to stay as long as I thought. So we'll just try to get him with the pulser then. Not a fan of the angle. Did he really stop behind that tree? This is one of the more patient small bucks that I've dealt with lately, anyway. We're just going to go reverse draw. I don't want to spook him. Spending all this time, he will go down. Alright, 2 bucks down already. So we will actually go over to where I was planning on starting this video. As soon as we claim this guy, and that was actually not an ideal shot. I think it was like neck bone or spine. Neck bone 2. But it works. There should be, yeah, 1 camping supply is over to here. Got a mule deer doe calling. Just want to hop in that stand just in case there's anything around. I never fast travel to this tent. I almost always spawn here when I hunt this map, so I don't know what might be spawning here. I've definitely had animals here, even just spawning here. But I'm not gonna sit here, really. I just wanted to look around. No sign of anything, so we'll just keep on moving then. See, I mentioned the 3 videos a week, and I also mentioned that the upload schedule, And if you know that, then this pretty much really isn't as necessary. But if you don't pay attention to the upload schedule, or if you want to get notifications when the videos go up, I was informed recently that that isn't always happening. So I guess the only way to actually do that is to actually click on the bell. That is on both PC and mobile. You can click on like the little bell if you're subscribed to the channel, and you'll get a notification when a video goes up. I believe for PC it's a email notification. I'm not like 100% sure because I don't have anything turned on for PC as far as notifications for other channels, so I can't say that for a fact, but I'm almost sure it is just an email if you have a notification setting turned on for a channel on a PC. So if you guys wanted to get notifications when videos go up, that is the one surefire way to always get them. And I think there's definitely something there. Look like a mule deer doe, but just in case it's a buck, we're going to slow down for a minute. Can't seem to... can't seem to see it with just the spotting scope. And I don't want to call because of where we're going next, which I will try to show in a minute, if I could see what this was. Wherever it is, it's hiding really well. Maybe I was wrong, but I thought I was seeing it moving. I don't know. We'll continue on then. So we're going to this tower up here, and I don't want to pull anything away from that. Is the reason that I didn't want to call, because more often than not up here there are animals. And we were actually just south of this tower where we came from. I wasn't planning on shooting anything over there, but we got a couple of grunts, and I couldn't resist calling them in to see what they were. So it was a nice way to start off the video with two... one decent mule deer and one pretty small one, but two quick kills. I guess the second one wasn't all that quick. It wasn't very cooperative, but that's the way it goes. So yeah, we'll get into this tower, and then I'll continue talking about what's been going on lately. I'd say it now, but I'm trying to focus on over where I was so sure I was seeing movement, and I... kind of thinking maybe I was just seeing some kind of like weird color on something that I thought was a deer, and because of my own movement, I thought it was moving. But just in case, and we're gonna crouch here in just a moment as well, I want to focus on that. So yeah, I guess I'll go ahead and continue talking, because I do think that was probably not an animal. So anyway, still been hunting for the holiday event. I've managed to work my way into the top 25, which was not my ultimate goal. I wanted to get at least top 10. I don't really see that happening based on the scores. Some people have done really well in this competition. There we go. That's what I like to hear. That is over where I was seeing that, but I really don't think that it wouldn't have spooked because I was walking. So I think it came from the other direction. I'm going to go ahead and put a dot there. It's right about there. Nope, not quite there. So I know if I leave render when I go to the tower. Hopefully we don't, so we can just get in the tower. And we've got a elk carcass here. Normally that kind of throws off the spawning when there's an elk carcass here for deer, but so far having two bucks down there just south of where we are now and buck running over there, it's a pretty good sign that the spawning is going to be okay for this hunt, hopefully. Anyway, gotta hope this isn't just a fluke, I guess. Pretty small bull. I think there's a carcass over there as well. That's what's cool about this tower. I had it here before the wolves were introduced into the game, and that's a decent bull carcass there. And there's two carcasses within sight of the tower, so... it can be a pretty good wolf spot when they both spawn. which is random. Sometimes both spawn, sometimes just one, and sometimes neither of them spawn, so never know. Looks like we'll be fine to hop in the tower, though, and that buck should still be in our render. There's a grizzly bear standing down on the road. Small female. Speaking of grizzly bear, ever since the brown bear and the black bear got the new fur, I want to know what's going to go, like, is the silver tip variation of the brown bear gone now? Or are they going to, like, redo that? Because I like the silver tip. I thought they were the cooler rare of the two, albino and silver tip, for the brown bear. Even though it seemed like they were a bit more common. There's the mule deer doe we were hearing. I'm going to give it an elk bugle as well. So I'm hoping they redo the silver tip, but honestly, I don't think it would look as good on the newer models. I'm not sure. Maybe they could pull it off, but I would like to see it reintroduced anyway, even if it doesn't look quite as cool as it did on the older models. I mean, overall, the newer models definitely look better, but the rare silver tip specifically, I think, probably would end up looking better on the older models. But overall, I guess the common looking better is an improvement that would be more acceptable than the rares looking better, I guess. So I'm hoping that buck's going to hurry up. I do want to stay here because it tends to be a good area, and we have that doe over there as well that's probably going to try to mess things up, which I can hear her coming in right now. Sounds like she stopped. Trying to keep eyes over that way. It seems like I have a lot more animals on this map kind of ignore my call and not come in than I do on other maps. Maybe it's just a fluke, really. Or maybe I'm speaking more animals than I think I am. I don't know. We'll get the pulser ready for this doe. I hope she's going to clear that brush first. And of course not. I'm going to give another elk bugle as well as a grunt call. Over here, where the doe is, kind of, I see a lot of mule deer over in there, especially when I get here, like, not long after starting the game, which not necessarily is what we did in this hunt. And unfortunately, there's a doe coming in from where the buck is, and I don't like that, especially if the buck's not far behind her. I got a couple of ideas of what we could do. I'm going to have to try to see. We got to take this doe. Got to be careful not to have the arrow hit the tower. I thought I saw... No, I didn't. I thought I saw a deer look around. Like it was somewhat spooked when I shot, but not seeing anything there. No sign of that buck yet. He definitely got closer, though, when he grunted the second time. So I'd say he is coming in. But I think we'll be safe just to keep calling, let this doe come the whole way in, and take her with the pulser. And I like that as well. Got a bull elk right across the road. Hopefully timing works out, though, and we can kill both the bull and the buck, or at least the bigger of the two if we can see them both. Of course, the elk's going to be bigger. The bigger, respectively, to the species. That's a pretty small bull, although you can get a couple of bulls traveling together, so we'll call anyway. I thought I just heard, like, movement out around 50 meters from something else, even not the doe that's here. Could be wrong. I don't know if it's just this map, or if that's been recently introduced, or what, that you can hear. Got movement over there as well. There's a bigger bull. You can hear animals from a bit further. It would kind of make sense on this map. There's a lot of high grass. So that could be why that is. And I hope she stops, because I don't want her to spook our bull elk. But I guess we can... Got a little low there. That was concerning. What happened to our buck, though? I'd like him to at least grunt again to let us know that he's, like, stuck or whatever happened. As far as these elk, small one's there. The bigger one should be significantly closer. It's hard to say where. It's kind of weird how animals that come from down there, I've had both deer and elk do it. They'll kind of come through the trees instead of coming straight, which is kind of cool as well. It's almost realistic, but there's our buck. He must have came into the original call first. Not too big. The question is, should we use the crossbow and get him down? That's the smaller elk. I definitely don't want to spook the elk using the crossbow. But if they get here too fast, we'll spook no matter what we do. The buck's coming closer because I can't see him anymore. That's one of the things about hunting like this when you're sitting in one place and calling. It's your decisions for stuff like this can affect how many animals you kill and how big of animals you kill in some cases. We're going to try to long shot that buck with the pulser because that's our only chance of not spooking that bull at this point. Don't know if it's going to work. Don't want to track the bull for sure. I don't think I will. Ah, they spooked. Well, we'll actually get probably more CSS, honestly, out of that little buck than we will from the bigger bull for the holiday event. I can't remember if I mentioned that or not. If I didn't, basically for the holiday event, you get more points towards your overall score because it's a major event. It's not like a single competition. There's a bunch of missions and competitions specific to the holiday event. And completing them and killing deer species, antler deer species, you get points equal to the CSS of all the antler deer species that you harvest. So this guy should be worth, if I'm not mistaken, like 50 or 60. Maybe it's 40. I kind of forget now. We'll find out in just a second. And usually elk around that size are like 40 or 50, so it's going to be close to the same. But we took the mule deer, and actually, I guess from a hunter score standpoint, it would have been smarter to take the elk because I've gotten well over 1,000 mule deer at this point. But we'll take the drop shot. Ooh, right through the nose. Must have caught neck bone and a lung, actually. Yeah, 54 CSS, so just slightly higher, more than likely, than what the bigger bull would have scored. I didn't see that carcass before. Didn't I look out there? Say something. Maybe you can't see it from the tower, but all right, get my bearings quickly. I kind of drew where we're gonna go, but I forgot to mention that. At this point, we're gonna just head straight up that way. Since we spooked the elk down there, there's no point really in cutting down that way. So we're about halfway in. We have how many kills now? 1 and 4. We got about 5 kills. Not too bad. If we'd have been a little luckier with timing, we could have had 6, maybe 7 with the elk. I think we were just getting 1 of the elk because of the way they were coming in, but I'll take the mule deer. The bigger of the two elk really wasn't anything too special. He was probably high 200s. I didn't think he was 300, but I didn't get a great look at him. But yeah, we'll just continue on, cut our losses there, and hopefully find some more elk and or mule deer up here. I actually didn't know carcasses spawned out there. I've never seen one there, so. Technically, actually, if you could see there, and I didn't notice it from the tower, you could potentially see 3 carcasses all from one spot. If you want the coordinates from that, it is in a previous video I did, 3 great locations on Timber Gold Trails, but roughly, it's X, -5604, Y, 1724. So if you want that to put a tower or maybe a tripod there, I actually don't know if towers are higher. I think they are. If you want to put a some type of concealment there for wolf hunting, that's probably a good bet, although we didn't hear any, which is kind of strange considering the amount of carcasses in the area. We'll probably hear one not too long from now. But getting back to talking about what's been going on lately, the rifle season here where I'm from ended sometime between the last uncut video and this one. It would have been just over a week ago, a week and a half ago roughly by the time you're watching this. And I was not fortunate enough to get another doe. I was very, very close to taking down a very nice mature doe, but she, of course, stopped in the one place I couldn't shoot, and she was kicked out by some other hunters, not anyone that I would have known, hunting below me, and since they were spooked, as soon as she started to step out into the opening, her and her, like, five other deer in her herd just kind of ran up the hill, and I had no shot opportunities, so... To fill my last tag, it is down to the flintlock season, although I have a pretty good spot in mind, so I'm looking forward to getting back out for that. Flintlock hunting can be incredibly fun, especially when you're actually seeing deer, of course, but the weather, the colder climate and everything, the deer kind of getting back on their feet to get food from trying to restore all the calories and stuff they lost during the rut from being run around and... all that, and also from hunting season being run around and everything. So it can be a lot of fun. So we will see, and of course I'll try to update you guys if I am fortunate enough to take another deer in that season. We have another bull elk, kind of in the direction we're going. That's what I like to see when there's animals pretty much directly where I'm going. And I have been asked lately, and I figured I should just say this, how to kill, like, big animals or whatever, especially, like, I've been asked lately anyway, how to kill big whitetails. This is usually for guests. I would say if you're specifically set on killing a big whitetail buck, ignore all females, because when you're hunting with a rifle, you just never know what might be around that you could spook unknowingly by shooting a female. So I would say specifically hunt bucks. And I don't know if I'd say ignore the smaller bucks. I mean, it can be something that can keep you going because it's also key to stay in the hunt for a while. Case in point, I was just hunting on Red Feather Falls the other night in an open multiplayer game, so there was plenty of people around hunting. There had been multiple 160-plus whitetails killed, and maybe 3 hours into the hunt, I ran into a 171 actually had scored. I did not shoot it. I spooked it, but a friend of mine got it, so... Staying in the hunt can be key as well, but yeah, if you can bow hunt, that is definitely, in my opinion, the way to go. You can be very successful rifle hunting as well, especially when you're ignoring the females and covering some ground and just general luck. I mean, getting a call from an animal that you might otherwise spook, that kind of thing can be key. So anything like that is important to... getting trophy animals, and of course the luck of the spawn. I didn't mention that. That's the biggest part. I mean, if there's no trophy animals on the map, no matter how long you stay in it, you're not going to harvest a trophy animal. It's as simple as that. But I, as far as I know, like, some degree of trophy animal spawns every game. It may not be an absolute monster, but there's a few pretty good ones running around more often than not, I would say, if not every time. I don't know the exact numbers to say that for sure, but statistically and just from experience, staying in the game for a long time, eventually you'll find a pretty good animal. Speaking of finding an animal, what happened to this elk? Wasn't that far away. It's gonna get up on this rock and call, but nope. He's still up there a ways. We'll just move into this next clearing. Ooh, looks like a decent one. Couldn't quite tell with the brush in the way, but no point in staying crouched and spooking him. He's coming into us, so we'll just wait on him. I'd like to get one more kill after this guy, if possible. Yeah, it's a nice one. Low 300s, I'd say. Maybe 320, 330 if we're lucky. I kind of like the fact that the Rocky Mountain elk have a lot more bigger elk, and at this point a 300 is a decent Rocky Mountain elk, where a 300 Roosevelt is pretty good, just because there's so many good Rocky Mountain elk. But it's kind of more fun, I think, when you see so many decent ones. I mean, it shouldn't be overblown where every animal's a trophy. And again, at this point, the 300s really aren't. I don't really take pictures of the Rocky Mountain elk unless they're like 360 plus at this point, and he's probably going to spot us, so we better shoot. When they start sniffing, I don't know if you could see that. If this wasn't uncut, I'd probably replay it for you, but it is, so I don't want to do that because that's cutting the video. He put his head back and forth. He was sniffing the air. They'll often take a few more steps, and then they're going to bolt. So take your shot while they're stopped if you can. I would recommend that. If you're prone, you might be okay, but if you're already crouched at full draw like I was, it's best to just get your shot off. 328, that's not a bad bull. I probably should have trophy shot at that for the sake of the video, but we'll continue on and try to get another kill here before the video ends up being insanely long. So yeah, also I didn't get to mention yet, the Call of the Wild, the Hunter Call of the Wild beta test went quite well. That was that a week ago today I got my video out on that? I know it was pretty late, so it would have been about the same time rifle season ended. That's why I didn't get to test it much. So it would have been a week and a half ago. I was rifle hunting, so I didn't get to do as much testing on that as I did did want to. It's late, man. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. But yeah, it went quite well. I think it's a good game. I'm not so much a fan of the AIs of the animals. They seem like they just give a warning call way too often, and it's a bit too easy. Maybe that'll be toned down. I hope it is, personally. But if they're trying to cater to a less simulator-driven type of audience, that's totally understandable. I'll probably still get the game regardless, and I definitely want to see what a North American reserve looks like. Call me biased, but that's my biggest thing I'm looking forward to for the release of the Hunter Call of the Wild in the spring. See, I don't know if you guys got to beta test that at all, and I wanted to make more videos on it that I did, but rifle season was in full swing. The last day I wanted to spend as much time as I could trying to get a whitetail doe, and unfortunately that did not happen. But yeah, I mean, what can you do? It happens. Timing was not great. Obviously, there's just nothing they could do about that. Originally, the test was going to be 2 days earlier, but I had finals then, so really, anywhere in that time period was not good for me. So, but yeah, I did get to look at it, and I was just happy enough to do that. So, yeah, I am looking forward to giving it a try and full release mode. And also, excuse me, I am planning on having a new graphics card by the time that comes out. I can't say that that's going to happen for sure, but I hope to. And if I do, I can hopefully run it on better settings than I did in the other video, because that was... It's rough on my PC, which is a... I mean, it's not a great gaming computer, but it's pretty good, so... It takes a beast of a PC to run the Hunter Call of the Wild on ultra settings, I believe is what they call it. So the max graphic settings. Got a grizzly bear calling out there. If nothing else, we can go pay her a visit and see if she'll charge us, maybe. Oh, we spooked a mule deer doe. That's not good, because she's running right through where we're headed. I wonder where she was, though, because usually they don't spook from super far away. We'll still give some calls. We might get lucky in something. We'll be over here, and if not, we can go ahead and see if we can get the grizzly bear to end out the video. I think we'll end up at 7 kills if we can manage to kill one more, so not bad for 30 minutes. And there's a few more things I wanted to mention as well, and since the video's getting close to the point that I wanted to end at, I should probably say that. So I've been hosting multiplayer games again. I don't know if you guys have seen the most recent Let's Go Hunting video. I talked about that a little bit. There's another elk carcass. So yeah, I'm hosting multiplayer games. I have to limit it to 5 players just because my internet can't seem to handle any more than that. Things kind of goes south usually when I do that. Looks like that mule deer doe is here just in the river. But yeah, so I've been hosting multiplayer games again, mostly here on Timbergold Trails, a few other reserves here and there. But yeah, if you guys see one of those open, I've been doing it most nights around 8 p.m. Eastern. So if you guys see an open multiplayer game, feel free to join. I tend to hunt by myself, but I mean, if you want to come and chat, that's definitely one of my favorite parts about multiplayer, the fact that you can talk to other hunters. That bear's quite close. Oh, my tree stand's over there. You know what? We're going to challenge this bear. you can talk to other hunters. You can kind of go off their success. I wish I could see it. Oh, dear. Hey, I am not done with you. Gonna equip my 7mm because that bear is not getting the last laugh. I thought she'd stand up or something. She was mad. Oh, sorry. Stand up for us. I think she just went down. I hope she just went down. Yep. Alright. I thought that was going to be a heart shot. We must have caught one lung or something. Yeah, right lung. Just a 16 scoring female, but we'll take a trophy shot just to end out the video. Guess I can't really call this a bow hunt anymore because we used the rifle. I was going to use the crossbow, but then she brutally attacked us well before I was expecting it. And we cut her in the foot on that second shot. I knew I was kind of off, but fired anyway. I did want to mention as well, I'm trying to get the last or the most recent subscriber hunt recorded. I recorded it with the winner of that, and it went quite well, actually. We had a really good hunt, and of course, the file got corrupted, and we really can't join each other's games. Our internets do not like each other at all. I don't know why, but we just can't join each other's games. It's kind of bizarre. So I'm trying to get that done. He messaged me recently and said he has a friend that he can join, because he seems not to be able to join many games at all. So I guess that's a product of not so great internet, which I can certainly relate to, but he said he can have a friend host, and hopefully we can record the video on that server. And I'm really hoping, I can't promise anything, because like I said, you just never know with the internet, both mine and his, not being so great, what's going to happen. But hopefully that can be out like early next week, if not later on this week. But yeah, that is all I have to say. I hope you guys enjoy these uncut videos. I really enjoy doing them to talk about just everything that's going on. So yeah, let me know if you guys have anything interesting to say regarding the topics that I talked about, specifically real life hunting. I love reading that kind of stuff, but anything you guys have to comment about that I mentioned, corrections, anything like that, let me know. And with that, thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave a like if you did, and I'll see you in the next one.